Imagine you have a box of Lego. You can stack them up in lots of different ways to build a castle, a spaceship, or even Cloud Cuckoo Land. The Adaptable guideline says websites should be like that too. They should be flexible so people can customize them, like making the text bigger or changing the colors on their own devices. Welcome to What in the World is WCAG? 1.3 Adaptable. Info and relationships. If you can't see the screen, how can you tell how the content is organized? This is a code thing. You need to ensure you use the correct HTML tags, the right ARIA landmarks, and put labels on your form elements so that screen readers can understand the page and relay it back to the user. Orientation. Your site should work whether I have my device in portrait or landscape. Some people will have their screens mounted so they can't be moved. Mobile first has been a design philosophy for over a decade now, so this shouldn't come as a surprise. Autocomplete and identifying input purpose. Setting autocomplete values for form fields helps all users by reducing the friction involved in filling out forms. I see you, marketers! Identifying the purpose of input fields in the code, like personal information or payment details, helps the browser autofill those fields correctly. It's just awesome. Do it! Meaningful sequence. Think of a document with two columns of text. It really shouldn't just read straight across the top line, should it? Websites and PDFs need to present information in a logical order. You can check this for web pages by turning off the CSS in your browser. Sensory characteristics. Click the green square on the right. Oh, wait. What if I can't perceive the colors? What if I'm looking at this on mobile? It's not on the right then, is it? Don't use language like this. Instructions should be clear for everyone. Adaptable. Ensuring everyone can access information in the way that suits them best.